Welcome, my students. Now we are discussing the subject applied hydraulics, and module 1 we have already covered the dimensional analysis, similitude, model analysis also we have done, and now we would like to start the third part of the syllabus in module 1, which is buoyancy and flotation. In this particular portion, you have a definition of buoyancy, buoyant force, center of buoyancy, metacenter, stability of submerged and floating bodies, determination of metacentric height using experimental and theoretical method, and we will solve some numerical problems. So, my dear friends, this particular portion, which is called buoyancy and flotation, you can observe in the boats, in a glass, submarines, shipbuilding. These are the application part of it. We will see one by one. To start with, we would like to see what is the session outcome. It will make you understand stability of submerged bodies, stability of floating bodies. In addition to this, you will also understand concept of neutral equilibrium. The important parameters to see the stability are center of buoyancy and one more center called metacenter. We will be discussing determination of metacentric height by experimental method, by theoretical method, and continue our discussion with some numericals. So, to start with, I would like to show a small important point. Normally, buoyancy, if you see, it is the upthrust. If I take any metal piece, if I take any metal piece and weigh its weight in air, it may weigh, say, 250 grams. If I take the same in water, it may lose some weight. Maybe it is 225 grams. It depends upon the volume displaced. Okay? It means that there is an upthrust acting against W. What I mean to say, any body if you take, its weight will be acting downwards and upthrust will be acting upwards. So, if the weight in air is say 250, upthrust is say 25, so the net effect will be 225. So, concept is, it is going to float or it may submerge or it may be in neutral equilibrium. Before I continue, I would like to show you a glass of water. You can see, are you able to see, my friends? You can see I have put a weight article. It is directly gone inside down. Why? Because its weight is more. Okay, if you put a coin, it will go inside. Same is not true for all. If I am going to put a heavy weight, it is going and settling there. Okay, this is, you can say, stable. It is submerged. So, what is meaning of submerged? It is fully under water. It is fully under water. Let us take this example. Are you able to see a cap of plastic? I am putting it here. Can you see here now? What is your answer? It is not going down. Why? Because it is floating now. It is floating now. I repeat, you can see its weight is less, the displaced volume is less, so it is floating, floating like a boat, floating like a ship. But this is like a submarine, it has gone inside. Is it okay? Now let us see very interestingly, suppose if I take the same cap, I have put like this, you have seen, it is floating. Agreed? It is floating. Now, suppose I change this to this orientation. Can you see this one? It has gone slightly inside. It is not floating now. It is inside, half inside, maybe half outside, that is floating. It is fully submerged, but not fully gone down. This is called neutral equilibrium. I will show you again. You can see, this is neutral equilibrium. Can you see? It is coming to one particular place and hanging there. So, it is underwater fully, but it is under neutral equilibrium. What is this? It is fully submerged inside. Is it okay? And what is this? It is floating. It may be 10% inside, 90% on the top. We will solve numericals on that. So, with this, I would like to start the concept. I hope I am able to explain to you what I am trying to explain in this particular portion of the module. Right? Now, let us start with the concept of buoyancy, which is called upthrust. If I am taking a metal piece, putting here, it is losing some weight because there is a downward force of weight and there is an upward force on buoyancy. Okay, we will see to it. The apparent loss of weight of objects when submerged in a liquid. This is what we say, it is buoyancy. Now, question is, okay sir, we understood that whenever we are putting any particular metal or any piece in water, either it will submerge fully or it will float on the half or it will be hanging in between. There are three possibilities are there, right? What is this buoyancy? Buoyancy is the upthrust. Upthrust, if you want me, I can put it like this also. Color. This is the upthrust. Is it okay? Now you can see, it is easier to lift the body when they are under water, when they are under liquid. It is easier because upthrust is already acting on that. Okay? When submerged, water exerts an upward force, Fb, that is opposite in direction to the gravity. You can see here, Fb is here and W is here. W is acting this way and Fb is acting this way. Is it okay? I am able to illustrate in this diagram. There is a point W where the weight W will act, it is called center of gravity, CG. Where the weight will act, it is called center of gravity or CG or G. Is it okay? Now, when the buoyancy force is acting, this point is called center of buoyancy. I will take another color. This particular point is B. We say center of buoyancy, where the buoyant force act. It means one is acting this way downwards and other is acting upwards. So downward is W, Fb is upwards. So wherever this W acts, this fellow is called center of gravity or CG. That you can see here W. And the buoyant force is acting upwards, the point of acting is called center of buoyancy. Is it okay? I hope I have given you some idea about buoyancy concept. Now, let us see next slide. Now, he was a great man, Archimedes, you can see before Christ, you can see 287. That man, I think you know the story, he was taking the bath in an open tub and he could correlate the weight of a submerged body. He says the weight of a submerged body is reduced by an equal weight of the displaced liquid. Mind it well, the weight of the body, say 60 kg, is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced by the body. We will come to that later also. But this concept is very, very important. It is called Archimedes principle. It is called Archimedes principle. Now, when a body is submerged or floating in a static fluid, the resultant force exerted, it is called buoyant force, which we say B is acting, B, it is acting upwards, FB. Okay, I think please take it, this F, FB. The buoyant force has a magnitude equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. It means this FB is equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. Okay, weight of the liquid displaced. This is the concept. It means the upward force will be equal to the weight of the liquid displaced. Now, again I am come to the same point. If the liquid is heavy, it will displace less. If the liquid is lighter, it will displace more. Now, this force will act vertically upwards through the centroid of the volume, which is called center of buoyancy or the point B, which I showed you in the previous diagram. This point B, where the centroid of the upward thrust is acting, which is called center of buoyancy. Right? Now, center of buoyancy is the point of application of the force, of the buoyant force of the body acting at the center of buoyancy. It always acts at the CG of the volume displaced. Whatever the volume it is displacing, okay, that CG it is acting on that, right? So, one thing is very clear, we have understood two things. Number one, in a liquid, if a body is put, it may get submerged fully. The weight is so heavy, it will go inside and keep. The other one is, it may float on the top. It may float on the top. And third is, it may be in the in between. It is called neutral equilibrium. So, these 3 points. Number one. Number two, any body has got its own weight, W, which is acting downwards. Okay? Number two, the upthrust of the liquid, which is equal to the volume displaced, it is called buoyant force. Buoyant force will be acting upwards. Weight will be acting downwards. Okay? Then, wherever this displaced volume force is acting, that is called center of buoyancy, or we can say B, point B. Wherever the weight of the body is acting, it is called center of gravity, or G. Is it okay? We'll go next slide. Now, let us see interesting cases. Buoyancy, as I described, it is a upthrust. Buoyancy is a upthrust. You can see here also. Right? If the weight 100 Newton of the object is greater than the buoyant force, then object will sink. What I showed you in the diagram, my dear friends, what I am trying to say is, if the weight of this particular object is say 100 Newtons, which is shown there. If the weight of the object is greater than the buoyant force, 100 Newton is the weight. I am putting here, you can see here. Can you see here? It is going down. It means the buoyant force is less. Buoyant force may be 20 Newton, 10 Newton, whatever. It depends upon the volume displaced. So, it is directly going down. So, the first point is, if the weight 100 Newton of the object, which I said 100 Newton, is greater than the buoyant force, then the object will sink. Exactly correct. Second point, if the weight of the object is equal to the buoyant force, maybe the neutral equilibrium, which I showed you like this. You can see it will be equal. Whatever the weight of the cap is there, whatever weight, same it is displacing, it's in the neutral equilibrium. It's not floating, it is submerged, but it's under neutral equilibrium. And suppose if the weight of the object is less than the buoyant force, the buoyant force is more, then in that case it will float. Like this it will float. So my dear friends, 3 points are there. 1 point is like this. First point is FB is less than 100, it will sink, it will sink. FB is equal to 100, it is neutral equilibrium, which I showed you for the second position, neutral. And the last one is the very interesting, when the buoyant force is more, FB is more than 100, definitely it is going to float. So mind it well, this is what we are describing now as the floating equilibrium, submerged body, neutral equilibrium. Okay? Now next slide I will take. Now illustration of floating object and neutral equilibrium. I think I showed you already this one. The neutral equilibrium is shown to you by this cap in this way. Can you see? Can you see? It's under neutral equilibrium exactly like this, exactly like this, right? So my dear friends, mind it well, the displaced fluid whose volume is equal to yellow volume, it is going to be the same. Now question is, what is this specific weight? Specific weight is nothing but density of the liquid multiplied by g. We can say rho of the liquid into g. FB is gamma of the fluid into volume displaced by the body. We would like to know what is the buoyant force. We say it is equal to the volume of weight displaced. What is the volume of plate displaced? What volume of weight displaced is V multiplied by gamma of the fluid. So this you should take care, it is also equal to, it is also equal to rho fluid into G into volume displaced. Mind it well, this is very important. I am talking about the buoyant force in terms of volume displaced, whatever volume displaced. Now you can see this cap, when I am submerging, the volume displaced are different. When I am putting this way, it is different. When I am putting this way, it is different. So volume of displacement is different. Hence, in the same liquid, the buoyant force are different. Correct? So once we understand this, we will go to the next one. Now we will talk about flotation. What is flotation? This is flotation, which I showed you earlier also. 1 minute. This is floating. Can you see? It is a flotation. Now I would like to know, what is flotation? A floating object displaces weight of the fluid equal to its own weight. A simple relationship between the weight of a submerged object and the buoyant force, weight of submerged object divided by weight of fluid equal to its own weight. It means the density of the object, the density of the cap and density of water where it is going to be submerged, this ratio is important. I repeat, so for the bus, suppose you take a ship, the weight of the boat or density of the boat material divided by density of sea water, that is important. So this ratio is very important. This object, whatever object, it could be pen or it could be metal or it could be plastic cap or it could be ship, it could be submarine, anything. So that density divided by density of the fluid is important. Okay, then my friend, everybody knows, if there is a wood available, what is the density of the wood? It is around 0.6. Density of fluid, okay, not 0.6, we can say, okay, I'll write 1.0. definitely the value will be less. Density of wood, you can take cork, कॉर्क डेंसिटी से 530 केजी पर मीटर क्यूब, बट वाटर इज 1000, सो 0.53 इज द रेशियो. सो द बॉडीज हुज वैल्यूज आर कमिंग लेस देन 1 विल बी फ्लोटिंग. अज्यूम दैट आई टेक आयरन. इफ यू टेक आयरन व्हाट विल हैपन, इट इज 7.85 डिवाइडेड बाय 1, दिस फेलो विल गो डाउन. द मोमेंट आई पुट द आयरन इन दिस ग्लास इट विल गो डाउन बिकॉज द रेशियो इज मोर देन 1. इज इट ओके? सो माइंड इट वेल. द टू इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग्स विच वी आर डिस्कसिंग हियर आर द डेंसिटी ऑफ द सबमर्जिंग बॉडी और द फ्लोटिंग बॉडी डिवाइडेड बाय डेंसिटी ऑफ द लिक्विड. द लिक्विड कैन बी सी वाटर, लिक्विड कैन बी ऑयल, लिक्विड कैन बी यू कैन से मर्क्यूरी, वट एवर इट इज. बेस्ड ऑन दैट द बॉडी विल बिहेव. राइट नाउ शिप बिल्डिंग एंड द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ रोटेशन, दिस इज अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग. ए सॉलिड 1 ton ब्लॉक ऑफ आयरन इज नियरली 8 times एज डेंस एज वाटर. आई हैव गिवन 7.85, इट इज सेइंग 8, दैट सीम्स टू बी मोर ऑर लेस ओके. इट मीन्स 1 ton ब्लॉक ऑफ आयरन इफ आई टेक, इट्स 8 times हैवियर देन वाटर. राइट, मोर हैवी. सो वेन इट इज सबमर्ज्ड इट विल डिस्प्लेस ए वॉल्यूम ऑफ 1/8 ton ऑफ वाटर, नॉट एन अमाउंट ऑफ 8 ton ऑफ वाटर. आई रिपीट, आई से इफ आई टेक 1 ton ऑफ आयरन, 1 ton ऑफ आयरन, 1 ton ऑफ आयरन इज 8 times हैवियर देन द वाटर, देन वॉट इज द वॉल्यूम डिस्प्लेस्ड, इट इज 1/8, 1/8. यू कैन सी 1/8 ton ऑफ वाटर विल बी डिस्प्लेस्ड. सो वी रीशेप द आयरन ब्लॉक इन टू ए बाउल लाइक दिस. अर्लियर नाउ वी वर टेकिंग दिस, ओके. वॉट आई विल डू नाउ, आई विल मेक द शेप लाइक दिस. दिस इज योर वाटर. This is your water, okay. So I have changed the shape now. You can see the shape is rectangle here and shape is now cylindrical. So definitely the reshape the iron block into a bowl and submerge displaces a greater volume of water. So deeper the bowl is immersed at the surface, the more water is displaced. In this case you will get more displacement, you will get more than 1/8. So that depends on the type of the shape of the body, how we are. So far I had given you 3 important concept. One is weight and buoyancy, they act opposite to each other. Number 2, wherever the buoyancy force is acting, that is called center of buoyancy. Right, next point I explain the importance of weight of submerged body to the weight of the fluid. This is very important. Their densities are important. If I am putting density of wood to the density of water, it will float because it is lighter. But if I take density of iron and density of water, it will submerged. But the ratio is 1/8 of that. Then second, can I vary that? Answer is yes. You can shape the ball in such a way that it will displace more force so that I can keep it up and up. That is the reason boats are of this shape. You have seen, no? Boats are not rectangle, they are of this shape so that they can float, they can be more stable and the passengers can be safe. Right, now let us see the next slide. Now flotation, when the weight of the displaced water equals the weight of the ball, flotation will take place. Flotation occurs when the weight of the ball equals the buoyant force. You can see W is FB now, same. Every ship must be designed to displace a weight of water equal to its own weight. This is a ship building concept. Whatever ship I am making, for example, if I am making Titanic ship and that is weighing say 2000 tons, I will see that it will be displacing equal to that only so that it can float. Now submarines displace a weight of water equal to its own weight, it remains constant depth. Number 1, if displaces a weight of water greater than its own weight, it will rise on the top, displaces the weight of water less than its own weight, it sinks down. So, this is the concept of flotation which we are using for designing the shipbuilding and submarines. Now, I will take an example just to tell you this concept. We are going to talk about a small numerical problem. You can see, my dear friends, an object weighing 300 Newton in air is immersed in water after being tied to a string connected to a balance. The scale now reads 265. I was showing you one diagram, no? Yeah, this diagram. Earlier, this was reading 300 in air. What happened? Okay. It was reading 300. Now, it is showing 265. It means it is losing a weight of around 35 newtons in water. Okay. I will go again. The scale now reads 265. When immersed in oil, same thing, first I am immersing in water, the scale reading is 265. Same I am immersing in oil, oil is lighter, you know very well. So, it will now read better reading, 275. Find the density of the object and oil. That is the question. Buoyant force in water, weight of air minus weight in water. What is the answer? You can see 300 minus 265, 35 Newtons. Is it okay? Buoyancy Fb is equal to gamma W into volume displaced. 35 Newtons is equal to 9810 into volume displaced. I can work out now. This is the formula. So, Vd I am going to work out now based on this 35 divided by 9810. You can also work out. It is coming 3.568. 10 to power minus 3 meter cube. Is it okay? Now, weight in air is 300. Weight is equal to mass into g, m into 9.81. You can see the mass of the object is now 30.58 kg of object. So, I know the object weight. Mass m is equal to density of the object into volume displaced. I am going to calculate the object density is equal to mass divided by volume displaced. If you calculate this, m is known here, you can see 30.58, volume displaced, I will change the color, volume displaced is this. So, we can calculate the density of the object by using the formula. Mass of the object is equal to density of the object into volume displaced, right? So, you can see 8571 kg per meter cube I am getting, right? Buoyant force in oil, weight of the air minus weight of the oil, if you calculate 300 minus 275, you will get 25 Newtons. Same concept, 25 Newtons, gamma of the oil into 3.568. 10 to power minus 3, because volume displaced is same. So, we can calculate this value will come to 714.24. Okay? So, the oil density is 714.24 and the object density is 8571. Is it okay? So, this is the small illustration which gives you the importance of volume displaced. Volume displaced is depending on density of the object and density of the liquid. Okay, and shape. These are the three things we discussed. Okay. Now, we will go to the next slide. We will be talking about now equilibrium. I would like to talk about equilibrium because any object which is put under water, I would like to know its fate, whether it is going to submerge, whether it is going to float, whether it will remain in the same constant place. Three things are there. So, now we will see one by one. starting from the beginning, I think I showed a photograph of a cargo ship, okay, floating object, density of the object is less than density of the fluid. The best example is wood. This is sea water. So wood density is 600-700 only, or cork, it is going to float, you know very well. So you can see density is less than the density of fluid, it is going to float, simple. Fluid density of suspended body and fluid both are equal, it will be remaining equilibrium there. Third is, if density of iron, it is iron and this is sea water. You can see here, this is 8 times heavier than the sea water, it is going to be submerged down, exactly like this which I showed. It is heavier, it has gone, and this fellow is lighter, you can see it is floating. Can you see? Now, the buoyant force is equal to specific weight of the fluid into volume displaced, density of the fluid into g into v displaced. This is what we have learned now. Weight of submerged body, as I mentioned earlier, the ratio of the object divided by ratio of the density of the fluid is important. Now, we will come to stability criteria. What is the stability criteria? Now, if you see stability of floating body, it may be a boat, it may be an ice cube, it may be ship, anything. An important application of the buoyancy concept. What is the buoyancy? Upward force. What is the weight? Downward force. Okay? So, there is a fight between the two. Now, assessment of the stability of immersed and floating bodies. This is very of great importance to ship and submarines. For example, the classic ball on the floor, you can see, this is a stable. This is stable. It is, even if you roll anywhere, it is going to come to the same position. We say stable. Even if you roll it, it will not go anywhere. This is neutrally stable. It is stable, but if you displace, it will translate. Correct? So, this is neutrally stable. So, stable, since the small disturbance generates a resisting, restoring force, it returns to its position. This is what is the importance of this. It returns to its position. This is called stable equilibrium. I repeat, the stable equilibrium is a position, even a small disturbance will make it back to the same position. That is called stable equilibrium. Neutral equilibrium is a position where it is, someone moves the ball to the right or left, it would stay put at its new location, it will roll and come here and sit if I push it. Correct? But still it will go and stop there. Right? It will go and stop there. Suppose you move this side, it will come this side and stop there. So we can say it's a neutral position. Right? The third one is unstable. It is a situation in which the ball may be at rest at the moment, but any disturbance, it is at the critical position. It is at the critical position. The moment you push it this side, it will keep on moving this side. Correct? No? If you push here, this side, it will keep on rolling continuously. Not like this, it will not come to stable position. Okay? So, this is called unstable equilibrium. So, we have three states of equilibrium. One is stable equilibrium, which you can see here. The other one is neutrally stable, where you can displace it, but it will come to rest. The third one is, the moment you push it, it will be rolling like anything, it will not come back. It will take some time to come back. Okay? So, mind it well, three things are there. One is the stable equilibrium. We will say stable equilibrium, one we say neutrally stable, And last we say unstable. These three positions are important in the floating bodies as well as in the submerged bodies. We will see how they are important, how to calculate the parameters which are required to meet its stability. All those things we will cover. So hopefully it's okay. I have done the coverage for concepts of stable equilibrium, neutral and unstable. I have explained you the concept of buoyancy, its up thrust. I have explained you the concept of downward force, importance of density of the object divided by density of the submerged body, and main thing is very important, volume of displaced bodies. So FB depends on that. F force buoyant is equal to gamma of the liquid into volume displaced, into volume displaced. So we have seen this important formula which we are going to use it always, this one. FB is equal to this one, very important, make a note. FB is equal to the upward force acting on a submerged body or floating body is equal to gamma of the fluid, which is nothing but density of the fluid multiplied by g into volume displaced. So this is very important to see the position of the bodies under stable equilibrium, unstable equilibrium and neutral equilibrium. Okay, now we'll take next slide. I think same thing I am showing. This you can see, it's a neutral. Okay, neutral. This is unstable and this is stable. This is stable. Okay, my dear friends, you can see this is a submarine which has got a capacity to discharge the water whenever it is requiring to vary the upthrust force. Okay, in one of the movies they have shown how they are changing the weight of the depth of the submarine based on that war requirement. It is based on the volume displaced, it is going to vary. Based on that, the upthrust will be varying. Based on that, the stability will be varying. So this is a very important concept you need to learn very carefully. Now I will come to a position where I would like to describe about the parameters which we are discussing. So far we have discussed the important parameters are density of the object, density of the fluid or liquid and shape of the body. These three are very important. These three are very important. Can we materialize this concept to one particular parameter? I also know that the density of the object is important, density of the fluid is important when it is going to be submerged or floating, then shape of the body. These three things are the primary. Now we will try to convert this concept into a parameter which is easy to calculate also based on the geometry of the body, based on the weight of the body, you can say the density of the object, and based on the depth of the flow. So these are the things which are required to be understood. So I would like to continue in the next session. My dear friends, mind it well, we are going to derive an important parameter to measure this stability, instability and the neutral equilibrium. What way we are going to talk. So two things are important which we have discussed: the density of the object, density of fluid, shape in a body. More important is the CG of the body, CG of the body and center of buoyancy CB or B. These points need to be taken, where their position is with there, how they are changing the position with reference to the stability, all those things I will discuss next time. Thank you.